We're getting close to the end of the year. We moved from a frenzy, abnormal seller's market earlier this year to a slow and soft buyer's market. Yet, the holiday season is here and the streets of New York are packed with tourists, overbooked restaurants, hotels, and heavy traffic. I'm Dana Sapir with Compass Manhattan, and here is your November market report. Welcome to New York. It's been waiting for you. Welcome to New York. Welcome to New York. Current inventory is dropping. New supply is 5% less than last month, but almost static when we look at earlier months this year. Based on absorption rate, however, we are still trending below the 6-month average. We saw 737 contracts signed this month. This is 4% down from last month, similar numbers to what we saw in 2019. An average activity for November is around the 800 contracts, so we are not far off. September historically is the slowest month of contract signed activity with about 700 contracts on average, and December usually ends with 750 contracts signed. Days on the market are trending up with a 10% increase from last year and hovering close to 5% from last month. With current market condition, we expect days on the market to continue trending up. Market pulse, which is what we like to review, the ratio between supply and pending sales, is starting to level up from the dip it has taken in the last few months. It stands on 0.36 and not expected to drop further. We are now actually seeing an increase in buyers' activity. Now is the time to buy, and the savvy buyers is taking advantage of this market. How's the rental market? While rent prices are stabilizing and beginning to slightly drop, they are still significantly higher than in previous years. Interestingly, the Upper East Side is the only neighborhood that saw increase in rent prices last month. As we near the slower winter season, we are seeing a slight increase in landlord concessions such as free rent and owner paid commission. Inventory has been going down and we also see less people looking to rent. Many are already settled and traveling during this time of the year. We may see slight increase in activity towards the new year and January as people move to start new jobs. What are the projections moving forward to the first quarter of 2023? So this December, with a slight drop in interest rates, we are seeing a bit more confidence in the market. Some areas in the cities are competitive with buyers on the fence waiting for a deal, and other areas are slower with agents needing to put a ton of effort to maximize exposure and generate interest. We are also seeing a slow yet stable return to the office, and with it, more people are coming back to Manhattan. Investors are still buying high-quality apartments, and we predict to see more of them in the next year. A question many of you are asking these days is, where is the market going? Are we going to see price drops? The reality is that Manhattan hasn't experienced a sharp appreciation like we saw in other cities and states. We have more stable market. Manhattan is Manhattan, and people will always need a shelter. Rents, for instance, have reached record prices, and you should ask yourself, would you rather pay 6% interest rate to build equity or 100% interest to your landlord? Another thing is, we cannot time the market. Real estate isn't a stock in a portfolio you can shift around and buy when it's low and sell when it's high. It takes months of data in retrospect to analyze this. Instead, focus on finding a place you will be happy to call a home. To summarize, the highly active seller's market of earlier this year has given way to a softer buyer's market. Inventory is rising and contract signs are dropping, but when we look at this data over time, it is within regular historic averages. Rent prices are stabilizing and landlords are beginning to offer more concessions. Where the market is heading in quarter one 2023? This question depends very much on the interest rate levels and if they will go higher, stay the same, or drop. But overall, buyers' activity is picking up as buyer confidence returns with stabilizing interest rates. International investors are also returning to the city along with employees coming back to offices. Manhattan market remains more stable compared to the rest of the country, and we expect activity overall to stay about the same with slight increase similar to 2019 city levels. Welcome to